Test you.
Like a lone ranger, not a stranger. I ain't scared of danger. My savior was born in a manger. Nappy head driver, that's me. Uncle Nappy, deliver the mail so you won't go to hell.
Nappy head prophet.
Oh yeah, nappy head driver. You can't tell me to stop.
From Genesis to Revelation, because you said that Jesus, hallelujah, and St. John, that he is the Word manifested flesh, hallelujah. Everything was made by him, hallelujah, through him. So, Lord, we just thank you for the whole Word, praise God, hallelujah, and giving us, amen, the ability, Lord, to digest, hallelujah, oh, my God, and apply and adhere and take heed to your Word, Lord. Hallelujah. So, Lord, I ask that you would touch the listeners, Lord, those that are listening right now, Lord, that you would bless them with an open spirit, Lord, to receive your word, Lord. Oh, Lord, speak to them personally what they need to know, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, I decrease that you would increase, Lord. Hallelujah. And I just plead the blood of Jesus up over every household that receives this in Jesus' name. Lord, well, praise God. Hallelujah. We're talking about the weapons of mass destruction. This is a series, praise God. Hallelujah. We're at disc 4, praise God. We're talking about abomination today, praise God. Oh, my God, there's some abomination going on in the nation. There's some abomination going on in the church, praise God. Hallelujah. You need to be aware of the problem so that you can grasp a hold of the solution and the problem would not reoccur. Come on now. Hallelujah, praise God. Once the cancer is removed from the church, praise God, it should not come back, praise God. But so many people, praise God, think that money is what got it going on. I just got to get some money. Nobody, praise God, is understanding. Who's understanding, praise God, that in this hour we still need the Word of God as our foundation? It's all right to have money, big money, little money, 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 praise God. But money, hallelujah, praise God, is not going to get you in. You can't buy your way into heaven. And you know, there are some things you can't buy your way out of, praise God. Oh, my God, hallelujah. But there's an abomination going on in the church. There's an abomination going on in the world, praise God. The definition of abomination is hatred or disgust for a thing or person, very unpleasant, disagree. Hallelujah. Hatred or disgust for a person, a thing or a person, it's very unpleasant and disagreeable, praise God. Oh, my God. See, God disagrees by his word. He disagrees with a lot of things that's going on in this hour, praise God. It's disgusting to him, praise God. Homosexuality is an abomination. It's disgusting to God, praise God, because God's plan was man and woman, praise God, and the devil is perverted. It's disgusting, praise God. See, when the devil get control of something, it turns into an abomination. Your sin can go from sin to an abomination, praise God. Oh, my God, hallelujah. And the thing about abomination, that spirit is so strong that once it gets hold to you, praise God, you don't want to let go. It don't let go of you. The next thing you know, God has turned you over to your own mind, a reprobated mind, praise God. You begin to do things that are very perverted, but you think you're justified in it, praise God. Same-sex marriage, there's no such thing. You can't find it from Genesis to Revelation, praise God. And I'm going by the word of God and not the Constitution of the United States, because, see, the Constitution cannot get me in, praise God. Oh, my God, it was an abomination when they wrote that, praise God. Hallelujah. Oh, my God, writing the Constitution, talking about we the people, equal, everybody's equal, praise God. But yet you had slaves, praise God. Oh, black man wasn't no more than 3/5 of a human being. That's an abomination because God created, hallelujah, man. The black man, the Indian man, the white man, the Chinese man, the Italian man, God created it all, praise God. And when he looked at his creation in the 6th chapter of Genesis, he said it's all good, praise God. And he went on and rested from his work in the 7th day, on the 7th day, on the 6th chapter, I'm sorry, the 6th day, praise God, he rested on the 7th day, hallelujah, but see, Anytime God is disgusted with you, you better watch out, praise God. You doing things and you think, well, mama don't understand, daddy don't understand, but it may be the anger of God kindled against you, praise God. Oh my God, get the abomination out of the nation. The only way you're gonna get that out, you got to repent. Oh my God, and turn from your wicked ways, praise God. The abomination is wicked, praise God. Let's go to Deuteronomy 25 and 16. Hallelujah. For all that do such things, and all that do unrighteously, are an abomination to the Lord thy God. All that do unrighteously, is an abomination to the Lord thy God. Oh, my God, you better check yourself or you wreck yourself. Look in the mirror. What is it that you're doing that you know that's not pleasing to God? See, some people, they try to defy God. They're angry because, oh, God, you took my mama, you took my daddy, you took my uncle, you took my grandpa. So they try to do things that they think is hurting God. You can't hurt God. You're only hurting yourself. Because, see, when it turns into an abomination, God is disgusted with it anyway. Oh, my God, he's about ready to flush it down the toilet. He's about ready to take your soul and flush you down to hell, praise God. Oh, if you don't repent in this hour, he's the same, hallelujah. His word will forever stand. See, heaven and earth will pass away. What we do in the world, it's going to soon pass away. The Bible says that your life is just like a vapor, praise God. Oh, my God, but see, his word will forever stand, praise God. That is the foundation. See, he laid a foundation when he sent Jesus. Oh, when he began to the works, his own works, praise God. The works of his hands, creating the heaven and the earth and creating everything. He laid a foundation, but it's all created by his word. When he spoke light, light came. When he spoke this, it came, praise God. The foundation of our life is the word of God. And if we stray away from the foundation, we're liable to fall into abomination. Come on now. See, Hollywood. This country is the lesser of some evils, but it is an abomination. Oh, my God. Because there are many gods here. Everything is free course here, praise God. Oh, homosexuals, hallelujah, adopting children. Come now. Oh, my God, bringing confusion into the plan. Hallelujah, bringing the abomination to the children. But God said, when he spoke through Jesus, he said, suffer not the children, but bring them unto him. Oh, my God, hallelujah. He didn't say bring them unto your perverted ways, your forward ways, but he said bring them unto him. Somebody's going to pay for the children that are suffering. Those children's lives is the blood is on somebody's hand, praise God. Where are you at, church? Hallelujah. Oh, my God, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Proverbs 8 and 7, I believe it is. Praise God. Let's see. Proverbs 8 and 7. Yes, the word of God says, hallelujah. For my mouth shall speak truth. And wickedness is an abomination to thy lips. Come on now. Hallelujah. God's word is truth. Praise God. Wickedness is an abomination to his lips. Hallelujah. Oh, my God, my Lord. Hallelujah. So see, God will not speak the blessings over your abomination. Come on now. He will bless them that bless you and curse those that curse you. But he's not going to speak blessings over your abomination. Come on now. Oh, my God, I don't care how much your homosexual behind cries out to God. Long as you are living in that sin, long as you are walking in abomination, you know what God said? Don't even lift up a cry to him. He said he won't even hear it now. Oh my God, see, they tell you about an all-loving God. Yeah, he's love, but his word is real. Oh my God, and there was a people that disgusted God so much in the Old Testament. He said, I don't even pray for him because I won't even hear your cry. Oh my God, hallelujah. See, we're not running nothing. Oh my God, hallelujah. We've got to fall in line with his word. Hallelujah. Oh my God, yes, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Proverbs 28 and 9, if you will. He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be an abomination. See how what God say? Turning his ear away from the law. Now, we're not talking about the laws of this land. We're not talking about the constitutional laws. And amen, because you mean to tell me that God would create a law? Come on, I'm talking about the God I serve. Now, I can't answer for y'all. He would create a law that the blacks had to drink out of one fountain and the whites had to drink out of another, that black people could not eat in certain places. Come on now. Or that the Indians had to stay on their reservation. He would create a law that would declare that a land that he already placed somebody in, that it would belong, that somebody else could just come and take it. Come on now. He would put a law in action that would take your home, you to work for all your life, because they want to put private retail in there. Come on, that ain't the God, hallelujah, the word. That's not the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Come on now, hallelujah. Oh, my God, hallelujah. But he said, he that turneth away his ear from hearing the law. See, the law, if you want to know the laws of God, go back in Leviticus. Go see what Moses, God gave Moses the laws, praise God. Hallelujah. Look in Leviticus, praise God. You'll find out the laws of God, and they still stand this day. Thou shalt not kill. Come on now, hallelujah. Thou shalt not covet. Come on now. Jesus took it and said, let me give you two things. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, thy soul, thy strength, and mind. And then he said, and love thy neighbor as thy love thyself. Those are the two royal laws that we live by, praise God, that we're supposed to live by. If we live by there would not be any wars. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. But see, Jesus saw your abomination in your mind. And he said before he come, there would be wars and rumors of wars. Pestilence. Come on now. Hallelujah. Earthquakes in diverse places. Oh, my God. He said, but the end is not yet. That's just the beginning of sorrows. See, y'all think y'all seeing something with the, hallelujah, 911 and the bombing in London. Come on. Tsunami and the hurricane. This is just the beginning of sorrows. According to the word of God, hallelujah. If you look in Matthew 24, praise God. Oh, my God, but abomination, come on now, is going to send you straight to the pit of hell. Either UPS will take you there or FedEx. Oh, my God, but God's word is real. Isaiah 66 and 3. Hallelujah. He that killeth an ox is as if he slew a man. He that sacrificed a lamb as if he cut off a dog's neck. He that offered an oblation as if he offered swine's blood. He that burneth incense as if he blessed an idol. Yea, they have chosen their own ways, and their soul delighteth in their abominations. In their abominations. Come on now. See, you do things, praise God, that's contrary to the word of God. If you're paying attention to what this word just said, praise God, in Isaiah 66 and 3, he that killeth an ox as if he slew a man, he that sacrificed a lamb as if he cut off a dog's neck. See, there was something wrong in the heart. There's something wrong with the motivation. Some of you all have some abominable motivations. Come on now. You'll do just about anything for money. Come on now. You'll sell your soul to the devil and preach on Sunday. Come on now. Oh, just so you could gather in tithes and offerings. Just so you could gather in that money. So you could get all that money to yourself. You and your foe and no more. But I'm here to tell you, there's some abominable things going on behind the love of money. Because the Bible says, for the love of money is the root of all evil. All evil. That means abomination, wickedness, hallelujah. Unrighteous. He said unrighteously, hallelujah, is an abomination. Come on now. If you turn away from the law of God, and God said, give and you shall receive. Come on now. He said, give, give, give. I'm talking to you preachers. I know the congregation is giving, but what about the pastor? What are you giving, praise God, except to your own family, your own biological family? That's an abomination, because you have turned away from the law of God. And hallelujah, he said that there would be meat in my house. Oh, my God. And he said, I'll give you the power to get wealth, but it's to establish his covenant. Come on now. Not to establish your vehicles, not to establish your house. You're going to get blessed with it if you're doing what I tell you, if you're doing what God tells you to do, praise God. Oh, get out of this abomination. Come on now. Ezekiel 14. Hallelujah. Ezekiel 14, this looks like 7.
Hey, we gotta go. Burn this one straight up. It's not high to your...